Good afternoon and hello everyone. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. My name is Lita Blazetti. I'm with the City of Calgary Youth Employment Center. This afternoon, I have Amy Osbaldiston with me from the Banff Lodging Company. And my coworker, Violet Rudy, there she is again. She's having some problems. She's supposed to be my tech support. I might have to be her tech support today. She's there as well, just to help run the event this afternoon. So thanks so much for joining us. I'm with the Youth Employment Center, as I mentioned, and we help any youth in the City of Calgary aged 15 to 24 with job search and career planning. All of our services for youth are at no cost. And right now they're available by appointment. So youth just need to make an appointment on our website and then they can meet with a counselor. So I would say if you're wanting to do that, now is a great time because we're seeing a little bit of a slowdown with intake. So there's lots of availability if you want to jump in and meet with someone. We've got the time for sure to meet with you. How things are going to work here is we're going to do this in an interview format today. I've got some questions to ask Amy. And then you as the audience, you can also jump in and ask any of your questions through the chat. We'd be happy to do that. Or we also have the grab the mic function. So on the bottom of your screen, you may see an icon that looks like a little microphone. If you click on that, it'll indicate to me that you want to grab the mic and speak on camera to ask your question. So that is absolutely an option. We love it when people do that. And I think it's a great way to make a good first impression. Okay, so am I done everything in my intros? Oh, we'll have some polling questions throughout as well. So Violet will be popping some questions into the poll so we can find out a little bit more about you, what kind of positions that you're interested in. So all of these things will make this a very exciting and riveting event for the rest of the day. I was wondering then, Amy, if you could tell us about the Banff Lodging Company.
Yes, so the Banff Lodging Company is an employee-owned company here based in Banff. We also have a couple properties in Canmore. So we have 13 hotels in total. 11 of them are in Banff and two in Canmore. But we also have 6 restaurants, 2 spas. We own the cinema in Banff, the Lux Cinema, as well as a retail rental shop. And our team atmosphere is more of a family-orientated style of business. We like to hear ideas from employees, how we can improve the guest experience, but also how we can improve the employee experience. So we have lots of different job opportunities in all of our different hotels and restaurants.
Absolutely. And we'll learn more about how to find out about those positions and how people can apply for jobs as we go along here over the next hour. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself and your career journey and what brought you to the Banff Lodging Company?
Sure. So I worked at a ski resort here in Banff when I decided that I needed a change. And I saw a posting for the Banff Lodging Company in human resources. And that is the field that I took in school. And so I felt like that was a great opportunity to try something new with a new company. And so it also helped that because Banff is a really small town, you get to know lots of different people in the community. And so I knew the hiring manager as well. So was able to have a conversation with her prior to the interview to learn more about the position and the company to see if it would be a good fit.
That makes perfect sense to me. That's a great way to get a job is doing that networking and getting a little bit about that inside information. And we're certainly offering that opportunity for youth this afternoon. Mm-hmm. So what do you like best about living and working in the Bow Corridor?
I think the best part is the cultural diversity. So we get to work with people that come from all over the world to live and work in Banff. Also, obviously, being surrounded by nature in the mountains, being able to walk out your front door and go for a hike or have some quiet time down by the river is pretty spectacular.
For sure. Is there anything in particular you're looking forward to this winter?
I'm looking forward to actually going skiing. I haven't gone skiing yet. That's on my list of things to do. Maybe I'll go on my days off this coming weekend. But yeah, one thing is skiing for sure. And then also some wild ice skating would be on the top of my list as well. So hopefully the lakes are kind of getting ready for that, you know, from a safety perspective.
Right. I don't know what it's been like in Banff. I know it's snowed a lot, but I don't know if it's been particularly cold like it has here.
Yeah, it hasn't
been cold here.
Yeah. Yeah, it hasn't been too cold. And it's kind of gone up and down a bit. So yeah, hopefully.
Better wait. That. You don't need to fall through a lake. That's
No, that's bad.
Okay. So I know at the Banff Lodging Company, like right now, you are hiring for people to work during the Christmas season, as well as other more permanent positions. Do you want to tell us about these Christmas season positions?
Sure. Yes. So we do have some Christmas seasonal positions. So they're short-term contracts just for kind of for the Christmas period. Right. When we see that, you know, our hotels and restaurants are really busy, we can use additional support. So that would be perfect for anyone that maybe would like to come to Banff for their Christmas break off school to earn some money and spend some time in the mountains. So those positions mainly would be working in housekeeping or as a house person. So working directly in the hotels to make the rooms clean and ready for the guests to be there. We also then do hire year round. So we have positions, you know, if you wanted to come for Christmas but stay longer, we certainly have those opportunities for more permanent positions. So they vary between all of our different restaurants and hotels, and even sometimes at the cinema or the retail shop. And then, you know, as we progress into the spring, our positions, again, we have availability for the summer if you're off school or, again, looking for permanent employment.
Mm-hmm. So you mentioned the house person. I noticed there was also some for cooks, like line cooks.
Yeah, right.
Restaurant jobs.
Yeah, right. Thanks for mentioning that. Yes, okay. Cooks. Yeah, line cooks, prep cooks, dishwashers. So all they're all entry level positions. So you don't need to have experience in any of those positions prior to starting with us. All of our training is done on the job. We train. You'll train with someone else who will teach you the ropes. So not to worry if you haven't had a lot of work experience, that's not a problem for us.
Okay, that is actually really good to know. And I felt like, oh, I should have actually asked that question if you needed to have previous experience. No, you just want people that are ready to work because it's a busy time. But you do get those days off to do a little bit of playing as well.
Yes, work-life balance is really important.
Oh, good. That is good to know. You know, I didn't have this as one of our questions I mapped out, but would you work at more than one property or would you only be working at one?
Generally, you just work at one location. We have had staff in the summer work kind of two different positions within one hotel. So maybe they work in housekeeping for a few days a week or and then the other couple of days a week they might work in the restaurant. So there are the opportunities for split kind of positions as well. But generally, most people do just work in the one location.
Okay. All right. And how old do you need to be? So we work with youth aged 15 to 24. So what age do you need to be?
Well, in order to live in our employee housing, candidates need to be at least 18 years old.
Okay. That makes sense. I guess you might be open for the restaurant positions to hire someone who's 16 or 17. They just would have to have their own accommodations.
Yes, exactly. So we definitely would hire people that are between under 18. Yes, but the housing piece is the most important factor. That is one of the kind of rules for staff accommodation.
Okay. That's good to know. All right. So how do you apply for a job with Banff Lodging Company?
Well, all of our positions are listed on our website. It's BanffLodgingCo.com/jobs. And we have all of our positions listed there. So you basically apply online, you create a profile, upload your resume, and human resources does not do all of the hiring because that is a really big job. So we work together as a team. Managers also hire their team members as well. And so all the managers have access to those candidates in those different job postings. And so either they would reach out to you via email or by phone to have a chat with you, or you would receive a call from myself as well, kind of the similar setup with calling or emailing to talk about the position and those kinds of details.
Okay. So initially you would do maybe a phone call just to confirm that, yes, the person is still available and ask mm-hmm. them a few questions.
Exactly. Yes.
Like to make sure that they can work in Canada, for example.
Yes. Sort of things. Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And then would there be another interview as well? Would they schedule a formal interview then, or?
Sometimes they combine it in one.
Okay.
So just to have that in mind that they may ask some questions related to your work experience in that initial call. The interview process isn't kind of a long drawn out process for us. I just want to mention, like, when we are looking at candidates and considering them, it's more about their attitude and their willingness to get to do the job as well as be a team player. So you can really gauge a lot by just talking with someone, you know, asking those questions. Like the typical interview questions are good, but sometimes it's more so your kind of instinct on their personality, more so than like past work experience, that is more valuable.
I really think that's interesting. And, you know, when I'm working with youth, I always say to them, your interview starts with your first interaction with the employer. Like, mm-hmm. because you don't know, like that first phone call could be your interview, and you should always be prepared anytime you're talking with the employer that mm-hmm. it's an interview. Even if they're not saying it's an interview.
So right.
I really like that. And I think that's important then for candidates to be mindful when they answer the phone, make sure that they're in a quiet place that they can focus and take that phone call. Mm-hmm. And make sure also you're checking your voicemail when you're looking for a job, because they'll probably
yes.
leave them if you don't answer the phone.
Yes.
Yes. And I'll say too, like, if you're a candidate and you're riding the bus and you think it's an employer phoning, it's okay to let it go to voicemail and then phone them back when you're more prepared to take the phone call.
Yes, absolutely.
Because it's better for you to be in that right mind space than to be distracted.
And two, it's okay, you know, if you do answer and it's not a good time to say so, we're happy to, you know, speak at another time that's more convenient.
Good. So I really like that. And I think I really like your approach, because in some ways, the first impressions is what the hospitality business is all about. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when on this phone call, it's a chance for the candidate to make a good first impression, and how they're reacting to you is probably how they'll react with customers as well. So you can probably make a fairly good judgment there. So wonderful. That is great, great information to have. All right. So you mentioned a little bit about the traits and quality looking more for the attitude than necessarily the specific work experience. And I'm sure there are some positions that you hire for that you do need, mm-hmm. you know, a journeyman chef or someone who's got, you know, can serve alcohol and all those types of things. But, generally it's that customer service piece. What are the opportunities, are there for advancement? So say mm-hmm. someone just comes and they apply for the house person and they're working as a house person. What opportunities are there for advancement?
Well, one of our core philosophies with our company is that we do like to promote from within whenever we can. We do like to see those who have an interest in growing their skill set or careers to have those opportunities. So we always will try to post internally to find those candidates that are interested. And so a lot of our middle and upper management team members now did start off in entry-level positions. For example, our current sales manager started off in housekeeping. We have someone else that, like a lot of our general managers worked in reservations or housekeeping, front desk agent. And we also have our president actually started off working as an accounting clerk. So it's an interesting, it's nice to see that progression and have like real life examples of how people have progressed their careers in our company. And because we are one of the larger employers in Banff, and because we have so many different properties, that gives us lots of different opportunities to try different positions over the course of our time with the company.
And it sounds like there's ways for maybe people to link their education to mm-hmm. a job further down the line as well.
For sure. Yes.
Yeah. That's great. That is great. So can you tell me a little bit more then about the company culture and what would help an employee to fit in and contribute?
So like I mentioned, we have a family-oriented style of operating. We like to have fun. We don't take ourselves very serious. We are professional and accountable to guests because that obviously is important for job security and the fact that we are in hospitality. But it's really important for us to just be down to earth. We definitely have a different feel to our company than maybe some of the larger corporate chain hotels in the world. So that's something that we're really proud of. We're really active in the community. A portion of our profits go back into the community to support community programs for youth and children and just community members in general. So it's just really, yeah, a really valuable aspect to our company. So those are the things I would say kind of set us apart. And the fact that we're employee-owned is also unique because we have a greater sense of pride in our work, wanting to see the company do well. But overall, yeah, we like to, you know, have fun, and that shows, I guess, we have lots of different perks and benefits. We want, you know, people to experience the company and experience Banff to its fullest. So that's kind of what's the most important aspect for us.
That's great. Can you tell me more what that means, employee owned?
Mm-hmm. So we do have a primary owner. His name is Wim. And so his vision for the company when he passes away is that he wants to leave it entirely in the hands of the employees because he feels the employees know the company best and know Banff best. So feels as though, you know, it would be better than some external company coming in and kind of taking over. So employees have an option after a year of service or 1,000 hours, I should say, to buy shares in the company. And so every year in March that we have that opportunity to buy shares and kind of share in the success of the company, you know, as it continues to grow.
That's great. So I like that 1,000 hours because I'm sure some people are part-time mm-hmm. and there's such a variety of different ways that people work in that industry. So that's what that means to you then is employee owned. That's exciting. And that certainly gives you some ownership for sure.
Absolutely.
About the position and what you're doing. Mm-hmm. Can you tell us a little bit more about the staff accommodations, you know, how that works, how you get into them, where they're located exactly? And
sure. So we have about 500 staff members that live in employee housing. Our employee housing is kind of scattered throughout Banff in different accommodation styles, from houses to more apartment styles, more townhouses. So it's kind of throughout the whole town. Once you're hired, you accept the job offer and you're hired on, you know, we accommodate whoever would like to live in employee housing. We will accommodate you. The only requirement is that you can provide a clean criminal record check. That's the only, well, there's two things. You need to be 18 and have a clean criminal record in order to live in employee housing. It is a shared accommodation. So you do share a bedroom with another person of the same gender as yourself in a house with some other roommates. So you're sharing the common spaces. There's kitchen, there's like lounge area, there's cable television and Wi-Fi. It's $13 a day. It comes off your paycheck every 2 weeks, so you don't need to worry about the payment. It just happens through the pay cycle. It's really social. You get to meet people, like I mentioned earlier, from all around the world. Most people coming to Banff do come by themselves, mm-hmm. so they don't have their regular, obviously, family or friend networks. So it's quite easy to make friends quite quickly here because everyone is in a similar kind of situation, being new.
Yeah, for sure. That's a really good point. And not only do people come from all over the world, they even come from all over Canada, I would expect.
Yeah, all over, from everywhere, really.
Yeah, that's exciting. And then, so what about for food? Like, are people to go grocery shopping on their own? And
yes, so all the accommodations have kitchen. So everything's there for you to use as far as the dishes and cookware. Okay. There are staff meals, specials at the hotels that have restaurants inside of them. And so there are opportunities for that. And then you also do get 40% off food and beverage at all of our restaurants as well.
Great. So that's nice too, to know that you can go to one of the restaurants and have a meal as well. Mm-hmm. Great. If there's any audience questions, we'd love to get them. So feel free to type in the chat or grab the mic. So that we can answer your questions then. So you mentioned that I have a question there from Alex. He's wondering if there's any spaces for single accommodations.
We don't have any single accommodations. The reason being is Banff and Canmore, it's very expensive to find your own accommodation and it's very difficult to find your own accommodation. So we try to accommodate as many staff members who would like or need accommodation as we can. So that is why it is shared. There is one position that does get single accommodation, and that is if you work at night audit, because your shift hours are completely opposite to everyone else's. So that's the only position that we have that would be a single accommodation.
Okay, because you have to sleep in the daytime.
Yeah, exactly. It'd be pretty hard to share a room. Okay.
But otherwise, the Banff is certainly, you're right, they are known to have a shortage of accommodation. So there's not really the mm-hmm. space for you to have that single accommodation. So hopefully that works mm-hmm. okay. And once you get there, you could find your own accommodations that are single.
Yes, that's what I was going to say. Some people kind of use it as a kind of stepping off point. Okay. They meet a friend or two and, you know, they get along really well. After a certain period of time, they're like, oh, let's go look for our own accommodation together. Okay. So there is, you know, a lot of people do that as well. I kind of use it as a nice thing to have because you don't need to worry about it when you first arrive. You just, you know, right away that you have a place to stay. So it takes that stress away.
That's true. You don't have to worry about finding somewhere to live before you mm-hmm. get there. Okay. So you mentioned that it's training on the job. Can you tell us a little bit more about what that looks like? Is there a mentor that works with someone, shows them what to do? Is it a supervisor? Like, how does that look?
Sure. I'll give the example with housekeeping. So with housekeeping, you would work with a staff member or a supervisor who would show you what to do. They would take you through the whole process, kind of show you what the expectations are. And then they would say, okay, now you try the next one. So you would give it a go, and then they're there, you know, to ask questions to kind of check in on you, like after, to see, you know, how you did and clear up anything like that. But yeah, so it's basically kind of a watch and then do type of training. When you work in, say, a kitchen, similar, kind of shadow the person, everything, like in all of our kitchens, a lot of them are franchise restaurants. So everything is very clearly labeled and there's a specific process, but it's all written out very clearly about how to make a dish or what the process is. But again, you're with someone, you know, to watch them and then try it yourself.
Okay, that's good. So you're not going to get left on your own.
No.
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 Okay, good. Even if you were on as a house person, there'll be other people doing that same job as well. Probably, yes. That you can check in with. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's usually someone like a trainer that's there to help you learn the ropes, and then off you go.
Perfect. Get those headphones on and screw up some bathrooms. Sounds good. Okay. Can you tell me about any uniform requirement? Like, is there a uniform? Do employees have to pay for them? Does it depend on the position?
So everyone receive a uniform. For example, housekeeping, you get a full uniform, sweater. Sometimes, like some of our hotels, you have to go outside to get between the rooms. So you get like full like coat and hat. And so really the only thing you need to provide is comfortable running shoes for that type of position. If you worked in the restaurant, you would need to supply like black pants, but you would get a shirt. Again, like black shoes, food and beverage, you get in the kitchen, you'd get a uniform as well, like a kitchen uniform. So again, just provide like comfortable shoes. There is no cost for the uniforms. When you're done working, you return that, and that's it.
Great. That's great. So provided by the employer. Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Okay, so how does someone get out to Canmore or Banff if they don't drive?
Most people would take like a shuttle service through the airport or Brewster Transportation. There's different services, daily services to get to Banff from Calgary, from directly from downtown. In the springtime, summertime, there's another service called On It. So it's a bus service as well. So there's a few different options for that.
And I noticed you had information about that on your website as well, of like how to get there.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Okay. Good. Do you need a vehicle once you get there?
You do not. Banff is a really small town. It's quite easy to walk. So for your work location to where your house location is, it's very close. It's maybe no more than a 10-minute walk to get to and from work. And then to get to the store, the grocery store, is, you know, maybe 20 minutes maximum. If you're the farthest away from the downtown area, so it's easily accessible. There is a town bus called Rome Transit. We do get a staff bus pass that is $20, just one-time fee, $20. You use it as long as you work for the company. So it's quite a reasonable the deal. So some people take that if they want to go a little bit further, or if they have a lot of groceries, maybe you don't want to take the bus, or sorry, you don't want to walk. In the summer, a lot of people just get a bike and bike everywhere. So it's a small, very close, everything's kind of close proximity to each other. So you don't need a car.
I think with the Rome, you could take that other places like outside of the town site as well.
Yeah, you can take the Rome bus to Canmore. You can take it to Lake Louise, which is awesome. You don't have to worry about anything. It's actually a very nice ride. And in the summer, they do also go up to Lake Minnewanka. So it's to some kind of like points of interest that are really popular with visitors. So kind of surrounding areas like Johnson Canyon and to Lake Minnewanka and Johnson Lake in the summer too. So that's also really nice.
That's a great option. You can still enjoy everything Banff has to offer, even if you don't have your own vehicle.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, good. And I'm guessing on this one too, but I want to ask, are there any jobs at the hotel where you do need a driver's license?
Yes, they would be maintenance. Working as a maintenance attendant, you would need to have a driver's license. And then there's one hotel that has a shuttle service for guests and staff because it's a resort setting just outside of town, like kind of on the border of town. That requires obviously to drive people in the shuttle bus. So yes, those two kind of are the main ones.
But otherwise, you don't.
But otherwise, no.
Okay. Okay, that is great to know. Any other questions from the audience? Pop them in, grab the mic. We'd love to get them. I'm curious, are there any other certifications or training that someone could have that would help give them an edge to apply for a job and with Banff Lodging Company?
Sometimes there's different courses you can take, like different customer service courses, or if you speak a second language, that always is great. There isn't really anything that stands out. I mean, obviously having like prior experience doing a job like helps. Even like if you were like, I'm the main cleaner of my own house, like that kind of stuff.
Oh, that's great to hear. Or that people like to cook maybe as their hobby.
Yes. Yeah. Likes to cook. Or some people really like cleaning. Like they really like the sense of accomplishment, seeing their work like finished.
Good. So do you want people to apply with a cover letter, or is just a resume okay?
A resume is perfect. If they wanted to include a cover letter, that certainly is welcomed, but it's not necessary.
Okay.
That's most good. Of our job postings do have a little questionnaire attached to them, just to learn, like, when would you like to start and why are you interested? So kind of get a little feel as to like the motivation and the availability.
Oh, so we've got another question here from Alexander, just around what qualities have employees who have advanced with Banff Lodging Company displayed?
They displayed a sense of pride in their work and being a big team player, willing to do whatever it takes to get the job done, you know, never saying like, oh, that's not in my job description. For example, I have gone, you know, in kind of busy times, gone to help clean rooms, like just doing whatever it takes to get the job done, to meet and exceed the expectations of guests. So it's really just comes down to like attitude, like really positive attitude. Those are the big things, like that kind of stand out, you know, like always kind of stepping up to help your team members, and those kinds of things are really important. And those are the people who you see have those opportunities to grow their careers.
That is great. I really appreciated that answer. Like, I think it's so important, that teamwork. And for candidates, when I'm working with youth, like, think about, what does that mean, teamwork? And mm-hmm. I think you gave some good examples, like you're jumping in to help and do things that maybe aren't normally your job, mm-hmm. but you're packing people up. You're offering to help them when they need that help, as well as that positive attitude of being willing to do things and having that smile on your face when you see your coworkers, when you're working mm-hmm. with the guests, all of those things. Like, I think sometimes that's underrated, part of customer service. And I think that attitude shouldn't just be for the customers. It should be for your coworkers too. Mm-hmm.
Yes, it's also really important to engage with your coworkers, you know, like everyone, like at lunchtime, like chat to them and learn more about them. And, you know, because a lot of times, like if you, you know, are working an entry level position and you work your way up, and maybe someday you are going to be that general manager and you have these people that you've kind of been with, working with for such a long time, you'll have a greater working relationship with them, and they'll have a greater like appreciation for you, and kind of it makes you more approachable as well, as you know, as you grow your careers, the staff will feel that you are more relatable to them.
Absolutely. So it sounds like those soft skills for mm-hmm. sure. That's important, and I think we don't always realize that.
Yes.
I had to coach a big group of youth from group job interviews before, and I said to them, you know, when you arrive for your group interview, don't go on your phone. Like, greet the other people that are arriving as well and have some small talk with them. That's going to help lawyers see that you're friendly and that that teamwork is important to you. And I think that's a really important thing for us to do. It would be easy to sit there on your break and just smile through your phone your whole break. But
yeah.
It could be a little bit better in the long run for you to make those relationships. And
absolutely.
Workers. All right. We talked about the interview process. So you said you do a criminal record check. Is that only if you're living in housing or is it for any employee?
It's just for employee housing.
Okay, great. And then...
And they don't need to get it... Like, you don't need to get it from in Calgary. Like, basically, once you arrive, employee housing gives you a letter saying that you're working and living in Banff, and you can go to the local detachment. Well, I think it's online now, but it's a much faster process if they give you the letter than trying to obtain it on your own prior.
So you can do that once you arrive.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, great. And then... had another question there. No, I forgot it. Oh, are you checking references?
We don't check references for entry-level positions.
No, that's great to know. So there's really low barriers to get in. Which is nice, though. I think that's why it's good. It's good. It helps when you are recruiting these frontline employees. And I think that helps for candidates as well, because I think it can really be tough getting out there and looking for the job, especially if it's one of your first jobs.
Yeah, exactly. And not every job that you may have had may have been the right fit for you. And so it's not necessarily like fair necessarily to speak to a reference from past employment. Like, we're willing to kind of take a chance and like see your work ethic and your attitude and your positivity. Give people chances, and that's important. So
I agree. Absolutely. Okay. So we talked a little bit about, how people become an owner, and you mentioned some of the benefits. Can you tell me more about the benefits if you're thinking of making a more permanent move besides just working for the 2 or 3 weeks over Christmas?
Yeah. But even if you work over the Christmas break, you're still considered like a regular team member and still have access to all of the perks and benefits that the year-round staff would have. So for example, I mentioned like our food and beverage discounts in all of our restaurants. We own the movie theater in Banff, so we get discounts at the movies on tickets and snacks and drinks. We also have the retail store, so we get discounts on gear or clothing. What else do we have? Lots of different things. For kind of, I guess, in the summer, we have free canoe and golf passes. We have free yoga twice a week for staff to enjoy if they're into that. Staff events. So coming up next week is our Christmas party, and we have summer barbecue, and we have movie nights for staff and lots of different things. And then each kind of department does their own kind of team events as well. Team building kind of events.
Do you have those more traditional benefits as well, like health?
Oh, yes, of course. Yes. So after 6 months of employment, you're eligible for full health and dental benefits.
Okay. So those are based on 6 months, not number of hours.
Yeah. 6 months.
Okay. Mm-hmm. That's good to know that you can get those other benefits as well.
Yes, absolutely. Another one that is unique is we actually have a employee like home buyers program. So it's like you can get a loan from the company to help with your payment of your first house too. So that's pretty cool.
So for a down payment.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So there's some long-term kind of benefits as well.
That is really interesting. So how many people live in Kenmore and how many live in Banff?
There's about 13,000 permanent residents that live in Banff. But that number, of course, goes up with working holiday people coming from different countries or seasonal workers. And then, of course, visitors. So that number can like quadruple in the summertime. In Canmore, it's about 16,000. So just a little bit of a larger town. It has a couple bigger grocery stores and a Canadian Tire. So just more like bigger amenities or more amenities, but still very much tourism driven and mountain-esque views.
Okay, great. So is it easier to find housing in Canmore than in Banff? Like if you were going to look for your own?
Well, we offer employee housing in Canmore as well.
Okay.
So that's part of the employment process. But it's hard to say. There's more availability, but it's really expensive. It's really pricey.
Yeah.
So
okay, that's what happens.
It's a barrier.
It's so desirable, right? It's so desirable.
Yeah. Yeah.
So
it's definitely.
That's how it goes.
Yeah.
Here's another question I have. Like, is food more expensive to buy from the grocery store in Banff or Canmore?
It might be a little bit more expensive than Calgary. I mean, it depends on what you're buying. Like, you know, depending on what your like preferences are. So I would say, yeah, the cost of food can be a little bit more expensive. However, there are different programs in Banff and Canmore to help kind of support food security. So for example, in Banff, there's an organization that decided they wanted to help rescue good food from the grocery stores that was otherwise going to be thrown away and give it to people in the town. So that's called the Banff Food Rescue, and Canmore has a similar program, but it's basically just they want to keep good food out of the landfill. So every week they have kind of a by donation, you can get some really nice things, and they're still perfectly fine. Mm-hmm. And then there's also different they're kind of like lunch programs. So like community lunch programs. So there's like a soup and bread program, or there's like food with friends program. So on a weekly basis, there's organizations that provide meals to residents, like for nominal cost or like donation, just to kind of create community, maintain community, and people some like, you know, home cooked meals. So yeah, so there's definitely ways to obtain food, like for quite reasonably priced.
Okay, that is good to know as well. Yeah. Would there be like a community garden or anything like that? And do you know of? Or
there is a community garden greenhouse, but it's just like private plots, like people
okay
for their own purpose. But yeah,
That's fine. I was just curious
yeah.
if there was an opportunity for people to grow a few things too.
Oh, for sure. I mean, you just have to sign up, you know, for that once they release the like next year's kind of registration time.
Mm-hmm. I understand. All right. And I think those are pretty much my questions today. So if there's any more audience questions, now is definitely the time to ask, because I am getting a little bit tapped out now, which is a miracle and rarely happens. Violet, can you think of anything that I maybe forgot to ask? I'm going to get her to come back in.
I'd love to know, with all of your experience that you've had at the Banff Lodging Company, what has been your kind of career growth there? And what is one of your best memories working there and with your experiences that you've had?
Oh, sorry, great question. Oh my God. What was the first part of the question?
What has been your kind of career growth at your company?
Well, I guess when I first started, there was just two of us working in HR. So we did everything. To give you an example, like all the staff events, all the, you know, getting the perks and benefits organized, the recruitment. That was pretty much just two of us. And now we have a team of six. So the company's grown a lot. And I transitioned over the, you know, the last few years more so in recruitment. So I've learned a lot, you know, labor forecasting and recruitment strategies and building relationships with partners from around the world. And the highlight just has really been speaking to all the different candidates. You know, that's kind of one of the best parts, I guess, of my job, that I get to speak to lots of different people and hear their stories. And, you know, when they say, oh, I'm from such and such a place, I'm like, oh, I've been there. And I like love to tell them that I love your country. And so that's been really fun. But yeah, I mean, it's all been a learning process because, you know, I've grown a lot. It's been 7 years that I've been here. So
that's amazing. Yeah. Incredible. Thank you.
Do you sometimes get to travel overseas to do recruiting?
I've only traveled so far within Canada.
Okay.
I could have possibly had an opportunity pre-COVID to travel to Europe, but obviously that is on hold, but maybe in the future. Right now, everything's online, which is great too, to still have access to lots of different candidates and meet different people.
Great. So Alex has another question here about accommodations. Mm-hmm. Do you have a favorite accommodations spot there in Banff, like from the ones that you have?
a favorite? They're all nice. Like, it's well managed and clean. It has all the amenities you need to live comfortably. I guess it just depends. Like, some accommodations are, you know, you share a house with four people. Other accommodations you're sharing with 12. It just depends on like the size. You know, some places are bigger than others. So it just depends kind of what you're after as far as like social aspect. But it's very like, the housing department doesn't really put up with much in terms of like parties or people carrying on. They're very kind of strict because it is a communal living space. So they want to make sure people are comfortable and everyone's being respectful. Everyone's doing their fair share of the cleaning. So it's a very well organized place, especially when you're dealing with, you know, 500 people. It needs to be kind of ruled a little bit differently than just, you know, like an apartment that is not employee owned or is not employee housing. And so I guess as far as like where you are placed, if you work with us, they try to put you as close to your work location as they can to make it easy to go to and from work. And it all depends what's available at the time that you're coming as to which place you get, because, you know, some might be full or not available. They're all like, they're all decent places to live. Like, I would live in any of them myself. I don't myself live in staff accommodation, but if I had to, I would.
Yeah. And you probably have previously.
Yes. Not with this company, but previous companies. And compared to other companies, this is really good.
I'm sure word gets around. That's small enough community. I think providing good accommodations for staff is going to help you with your retention and even your recruiting. And so probably there's like a person that's a contact person for you if you had anything you needed to talk about, right? As far as your goals, like if something's going wrong, like the hot water's not working or like...
Yes. It's a whole separate department of three. So that's their full-time job. Yeah.
Cool. I'd love to know if there's any other questions from our audience before we completely wrap up here today. And Violet, I don't know if you have any other questions. Last call for questions. It sounds like a really nice opportunity for someone to come live in Banff and have a new experience for sure.
Yeah, it's definitely one of those places that is fun and exciting. It's you kind of you get to help create good memories for people. Like personally, like, you know, if I see someone struggling with, like, they're on their phone or looking at a map and they're like at a street corner wondering where to go, like asking them, do you need help? Because, or, you know, seeing someone's like looking at a menu of a restaurant, you're like, don't go there, go over, you know? Yeah. So it's like, you get to help create people's vacations and give them a good experience. And I really like that. Yeah, it's just, it has a good vibe. Our, I guess, age group is 18 to 35. That's like a quite a large demographic that we have working and living in Banff. So it's just, it's a fun environment because everyone is like-minded and, you know, you can be as active as you want, you know, go out and meet people to go for hikes with or go skiing with or, you know, go have a beer with. So there's like something for everyone. I would say if you're like a big fan of city life, then maybe not, but you have to like obviously nature and animals. And so
sometimes you don't know until you try it either.
Absolutely. Yeah. And so people, they come on vacation and they turn around and go home and then pack their suitcase and come back. Or our owner, Wim, he was backpacking from Northern Canada to Panama and stopped, and he was hitchhiking and he stopped in Banff to check it out. And 40 odd years later, he's still here. So it's, there's a lot of stories like that of people who have come and thinking, I'm just going to stay for a winter season. I'm just going to stay for a summer season. And yeah, 10, 15, 20, 40 years later, they're still here. So
that's nice. Mm-hmm. Well, it doesn't look like we have any more questions, so I think we'll wrap it up. And I would say this is our last virtual event for 2021. I don't have any more scheduled this month. So I will talk to you again in the audience in the new year. Our employer spotlight for next month is good food. So that'll be a great opportunity for people to learn about food production line. But for now, Banff Lodging Company, they are hiring for the Christmas season and beyond. You can check out their website to apply for jobs. It sounds like a really fun way to spend a few weeks if you've got time off here over the Christmas break, or on a more permanent basis. So thank you so much, Amy. Thanks to the audience for your questions. And thank you, Violet. And I'll say goodbye for now.
Thank you. Thanks for attending, everyone.
Wonderful. Bye-bye.
Bye.